The pretty colored splotches representing the dulcet tones of Family Life's radio network painted across the map of New York and Pennsylvania are more than just happy colors. However, when looking at this map, we recognize that listeners may have some questions. Why so many splotches? Why splotches instead of dots? And the ever popular, "This is great, but why can't I hear your radio station?" The answer we give is usually something along the lines of, "We're working on it," because like the dreaded Facebook relationship status, it's complicated. If distance, hills, tall buildings, particularly robust trees, or towers of any kind stand between the Family Life radio station transmission site and the wishing to be a listener's radio, the signal is blocked. That's why the coverage map is so blotchy. Unlike your college roommate's Facebook, Family Life is honest about their level of connection with potential listening partners. To reach people with Christian music, biblical teaching, witty banter, and children's programs, Family Life has to acquire three things. 1. A radio station. 2. FCC approval of said radio station. And 3. The physical equipment to broadcast the radio station out to listeners. Side note, the term radio station refers to the specific radio wave frequency in a defined area with designated call letters at a certain power level. For example, 103.1 FM in Bath, WCAK, is a radio station. Therefore, Family Life isn't a radio station, it's a non-profit company that owns radio stations. Okay, now. Here in the United States, everything radio and television is controlled by the Federal Communications Commission, or the FCC. They've divided all radio stations into two categories, commercial and non-commercial educational, and set rules for both types. Say you own the radio station 89.1 FM and you want to play heavy metal music paid for by advertisements from various businesses. The FCC says 89.1 FM can only be used as a non-commercial educational station. And one of the rules for that type of station is that you cannot use advertisements to pay for the content you play. You also have to prove to the FCC that the programming you are providing is in some way educational and benefits the community. We're not going to get into any arguments about music genres here, but we are going to point out that on 89.1 FM out of the Friendship, New York area, WCOV, you'll hear programs about money management, parenting, ethics, and twice a year a share-a-thon, because 89.1 is also 100% listener supported. It's one of Family Life stations. So to get the refreshing Family Life radio to the people, someone must start the process with research. This person, who is knowledgeable, patient, tenacious, and passionate, must take all the FCC guidelines, topographical maps, math equations, and colorless places together to figure out where it might be possible to build a radio tower. That man is the CEO of Family Life, Rick Snavely. Rick sits down at his computer, takes his 40 years of radio experience and various computerized topographical depictions, douses them with lots of prayer, and discovers the next radio tower location. Once he has a potential location candidate, he sends his findings to Jim, who runs it through even more computer software. If the newly discovered location is authenticated, then Jim files an application with the FCC. Once the FCC gives the go-ahead, an invisible timer starts. The approved parties have exactly 3 years in which to begin broadcasting their radio station at the approved location, or they lose their FCC approval. The FCC also approves radio station call letters, which the owner of the radio station gets to choose. Fun fact, we've been leaving coded messages in our call letters since the very first Family Life radio station. Each Family Life call sign has a bit of the gospel fitted into the acronym. For example, 107.3 WCOH in Dubois, Pennsylvania, means where Christ offers hope. To find out what your local call letters stand for, you can check out our website. Okay. Back to the story. To begin broadcasting, Family Life must purchase and or build a tower, antenna, transmitter, and building to house said transmitter and other electronics. The tower is the most expensive part. One tower can cost over $60,000. Plus, there's the cost of getting equipment and materials up to the location. In order to broadcast a radio station out to as many people as possible, towers are built on super tall, lonely, remote hilltops. This can create some unique engineering challenges. Family Life currently has 4 guys on their tower, transmitter, antenna building team. John, Jonathan, Ryder, and Preston. Each brings 2 key things to the job. Keen problem-solving skills and a flagrant disregard for heights. There's technical knowledge of various electronics there too, but mostly it's the not scared of heights thing.
So we broke for lunch and went to the lodge. And the guys goes, "Were you the guys on the tower?" And we're like, "Yeah." He goes, "You're nuts."
These guys spend their summer traveling all over New York and Pennsylvania building new towers and performing various maintenance tasks on the sites that already exist. In total, Family Life owns or leases 66 radio stations. We're in the process of upgrading 6 of those. In addition, we are FCC approved to add 4 new stations to our arsenal. That's a total of 70 radio stations for those playing along at home. We have to broadcast from the upgraded and new sites before the FCC approved 3 years are up, or we'll have to start the process all over again. That's 10 stations with ticking timers. It's a lot. This is where you come in. If you know electronics, have a disrespectful indifference to the laws of physics, and you'd like to travel, we'd love for you to join our team of tower-climbing, problem-solving, gravitational rebels who keep Family Life Radio alive and broadcasting. If God has blessed you financially, and you want to be part of building a towering legacy, we need money to build and maintain our towers, transmitters, antennas, and buildings. But most importantly, if you love Jesus and believe in sharing the gospel, we need your prayers. You know how this goes now, so be praying for things like wisdom to find good sites, FCC approval of what we're doing, granting of building materials, safety of our staff, and for the longevity of our equipment. So, now you know. If you can't hear Family Life Radio where you live, we're working on it. Promise.